What's up, guys? My name is Brandon, and today Apple released iOS 14.8 to the public about a month and a half after the release of iOS 14.7.1 and just weeks before the release of iOS 15. And in addition to this iOS release, we also got iPadOS 14.8, watchOS 7.6.2, and macOS Big Sur 11.6. But of course, in this video, we're talking all about iOS and iPadOS and what's new, along with when to expect iOS 15 and if we will see any more iOS 14 updates or not. So let's go ahead and take a look at the size of this update. And you can see here on my iPhone 12, this update came in at around 307 megabytes on this device, but of course it will vary depending on your device and the version you're coming from. And if you're not seeing this update, you may need to delete your beta profile. I actually had to delete my beta profile because this update was not appearing in my software update section until I deleted that. So that could also indicate, and probably will indicate, that we are not going to be seeing any more iOS 14 betas since we are going into iOS 15, of course. So let's go and check out the build number for this update. So if we go to our settings, general about 14.8, you can see the build here is 18H17. And if we go down to the modem firmware down here, that is actually unchanged yet again at 1.80.02. So we have not had a modem update in quite a while now. So now what's new here in iOS 14.8? And when you tap on learn more, when you see the updates, all it says here is that this update provides important security updates and is recommended for all users. That's all it says. It's very vague. But if we go to Apple's security page, we can actually see that there are two pretty big security patches in this update. So we have this WebKit bug, and the impact is processing maliciously crafted web content may lead to arbitrary code execution. Apple is aware of a report that this issue may have been actively exploited. So it looks like this bug was being used out in the wild prior to iOS 14.8. And you can see the description of the fix is a use after free issue was addressed with improved memory management. But by far the more important bug that was fixed is this core graphics bug right here. So you can see it says, processing a maliciously crafted PDF may lead to arbitrary code execution. Apple is also aware of a report that this issue may have been actively exploited, and the description is an integer overflow was addressed with improved input validation. Now, WebKit bugs are always dangerous out in the wild, but the big story with iOS 14.8 is going to be that core graphics patch, because that is one of the infamous Pegasus spyware bugs that is codenamed Forced Entry. And that was one that was being actively exploited for several months by the NSO group, who targeted and successfully hacked Bahraini activists' iPhones using this specific bug. And this was major news last month. I mean, a ton of publications were talking about this. This was all over the place. So right when I saw that, I knew exactly what this update patched. And that's going to be pretty major news, like I said. So, you know, this is a major bug fix, and it likely does not affect you unless you were a Bahraini activist. But still, it's something that you don't want to ever have the chance of affecting you on your iPhone. So not to mention that WebKit bug was also actively exploited. So that's one that you definitely want to make sure you're updated for, because that's not going to target specific people. It could happen to you. So you definitely want to make sure you update so you get the patches for both of those bugs that were being used or being exploited out in the wild. But as far as the release notes go, there's really been, you know, nothing mentioned in Apple's release notes since like iOS 14.5 several months ago. So it's no different for iOS 14.8. Really nothing mentioned in the release notes at all. Nothing really, you know, that big or that major that most people will care about. So it's pretty interesting, but also expected. I mean, we are near the end of the cycle for iOS 14. So there's really only so much left for Apple to do, while most of their focus right now is on iOS 15, because of course, every device that can run iOS 14 can also run iOS 15. So Apple is of course focusing mainly on that next big iOS release. Now, as far as bugs and bug fixes go, the 15 second Apple Music bug and the green tint issues both appear to be fixed, as I've not seen or heard anybody talking about that for months, either one of those two issues. So those seem fixed. However, I am still having a poor experience with the AirPlay to HomePod feature. So when I go here and, you know, AirPlay to one of my HomePods, it's really laggy. Sometimes the music queue doesn't show up properly. Just a ton of issues with that still. It's been like that for pretty much the entire iOS 14 lifecycle, especially with the handoff to the HomePod mini. It's really bugged out. iOS 15 fixes it somewhat, but it's still pretty slow. So Apple is still working on that, but don't expect it to get any better here with 14.8. And as far as performance goes, performance feels really good here on iOS 14.8, but really it's going to be the exact same as 14.7.1 in my opinion. However, the Geekbench scores tell kind of a different story. I mean, we got a 1600 single core and a 4061 multi-core score, which is extremely strong. If we take a look here at 14.7.1, we had a 1594 and a 4039. So some nice improvements in both the single core and the multi-core. And I've also seen reports of people saying that applications are faster, Safari is faster, things just feel better. So you might see a minor performance boost, but I would not expect anything major at all. And again, to me personally, it feels the same as 14.7.1, but these Geekbench scores, you know, do tell that it might be slightly improved here on the performance front. But as far as battery life goes, battery life was fine for me on iOS 14.7.1, and it was the same for most people. I really didn't have too many people complaining about battery life on 14.7.1. But, you know, I am mainly using iOS 15 now, but I would not expect anything to change here with battery life on 14.8. So if you're having bad battery life in 14.7.1, you very well could still have that in 14.8. Now, of course, there is always the possibility that this actually fixes battery drain for you. But for most people, I'd say 99% of people, battery life is going to be about the same as it was on 14.7.1, just because this is a simple security patch update and really nothing else was touched. So should you update to iOS 14.8? And I say absolutely. I mean, this is a must update in my opinion, just from a security standpoint. Now, if you're planning on updating to iOS 15, then you could wait. I mean, honestly, we're going to get iOS 15 in a couple of weeks, so you could just go ahead and wait. But if you're not planning to update to iOS 15 right away, go ahead and install iOS 14.8 as soon as possible, just because it does have some pretty important security patches. All right, so now what is next for Apple? And the first thing I want to address actually is if this is going to be the final update for iOS 14. And I think that 14.8 is likely the final major iOS 14 release, since all devices that can run iOS 14 can also run iOS 15. But some may opt to stay on iOS 14 after iOS 15 releases, and it's looking like Apple will actually allow those users to just install security updates, like point updates, like 14.8.1, 14.8.2, and so on. And you'll be able to install those without needing to update all the way to iOS 15. So for that reason, I can see multiple versions of iOS 14.8, you know, coming over the next several months. Now, as for iOS 15, I would expect to see the RC build get released tomorrow on the 14th. For both public beta testers and for developers. So we should see the RC build of iOS 15 on the 14th after Apple's event. Of course, the iPhone 13 launch event is tomorrow, Tuesday on the 14th. And then as far as the final public release of iOS 15, I would expect that to come the following week. So if I had to guess a specific day, I would say Wednesday the 22nd, but it could be any day on the week of the 20th. When we see iOS 15 get released to the public. And of course, we will see the new iPhones come out right there at the end of the week on the 24th. So next week is going to be very, very busy and very fun for you guys and also for me here on the channel. But that's what I'm expecting for iOS 15 and of course for the iOS 14.8.x updates that could possibly be coming in the future. But anyways, guys, there you have it. That is iOS 14.8. Let me know what you guys think about this update down in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, I would appreciate it if you gave it a thumbs up. And of course, make sure you subscribe for a ton of iOS 15 coverage coming very soon, because I know a lot of you guys are just on iOS 15 right now and just waiting for iOS 15 coverage and not 14.8 or iOS 14 stuff. But luckily, this will probably be one of the last iOS 14 videos I ever make. So we're moving on to iOS 15 very, very soon. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.